Hello everybody, you are welcome to this channel. I am Atanu Betal. In this video lecture, we discuss about the differences between carbon dioxide and silicon dioxide. Means our topic is that silicon dioxide is a network solid having high melting point, while carbon dioxide consists of discrete gaseous molecules at room temperature. So this is the topic of discussions. And before starting discussions about this topic, I would like to remind you that if you are new to this channel or you do not subscribe this channel, then subscribe it right now. Let's start the discussion about this topic. The topic is the silicon dioxide. Look at this, the structure of silicon dioxide. In this structure, the silicon dioxide is forming a polymeric network type structure. So silicon and oxygen forming a polymeric structure, tetrahedral is surrounded polymeric structures, and for this reason the silicon silicon dioxide is a solid substance and having high melting point due to its polymeric structures. Due to its polymeric structure, here the substance is hard and solid substance, and the substance has high melting point. Okay, substance has high melting point due to its network structures of the tetrahedral surrounding of silicon by four oxygen atoms, silicon forming four covalent bond with other oxygen, and this is a tetrahedral order of arrangement. Okay, so for this arrangement of the silicons, where silicon forming a long network chain structure, so for this reason the silicon dioxide is solid and have high melting point, because high heat energy is required to break this network structures. To break this network structure of the silicon dioxide, higher heat energy is required. And compared to the carbon dioxide, in case of carbon dioxide, here carbon contains p orbital, and this p orbital of oxygen and p orbital of carbon can form a pi bond. Okay, in this case carbon forming pi bond with the oxygen atom, carbon double bond, and carbon dioxide does not form this type of discrete network type structure, because for carbon it is not possible to form this type of structures. Here carbon and oxygen, the p orbitals of carbon and oxygen come closer and form the pi bonding with the lateral overlap of the two p orbitals, mean p orbital of oxygen and p orbital of carbon. They form the lateral overlapping, means if we see the orbital structures of carbon dioxide, then you can see this structure. These structures, you can see they have the carbon having this 2pz orbital and 2py orbital. In this case, carbon having unhybridized orbital on it. It is sp hybridized, so the unhybridized orbital present in carbon can overlap with the p orbital of oxygen. Can overlap with this p orbital of the oxygen to form the carbon dioxide molecule, but in this case carbon dioxide molecule is formed by the lateral overlap of the p orbitals of oxygen and carbon. But in case of the silicon dioxide, the silicon size is bigger and oxygen size is small, and for this reason this type of pi bonding is not possible for the case of silicon oxide. And as a result, in the case of silicon oxide, this type of silicon oxygen double bond double bond. This type of bond is not possible, means this structure is not possible. So for this reason, SiO2 is does not form the SiO2 in this form, but carbon dioxide is CO2 can form double bond because of the lateral overlap of the p orbitals of carbon and oxygen. Lateral overlapping, this pi bond can be formed here. But in case of silicon dioxide, the silicon is larger in size than oxygen and cannot form the pi orbital, pi bonding by overlapping, lateral overlapping of two pi orbitals. So for this reason, the silicon dioxide is a hard substance and having high melting point, but carbon dioxide is a discrete molecules of CO2. Here carbon dioxide contains the single molecules, okay. Carbon dioxide molecule have only weak van der Waals force of attraction present, but there is no network like the network solid of silicon dioxide. In case of silicon dioxide, this type of network structure is formed, and due to this network structure, these are solid substance and having high melting point, and carbon dioxide is a gaseous substance, and at room temperature it contains the discrete or single molecules of carbon dioxide. Single molecule of carbon dioxide do not form any network structure. The same reason why carbon dioxide cannot form the solid substance, and carbon dioxide why not a solid substance, the same reason can be used to explain this question. So this is the discussions about the structural differences between carbon dioxide and the silicon dioxide. This you can also write the same answer for the question that what are the differences between the structures of carbon dioxide and silicon dioxide. In this case, you can find this differences that silicon dioxide is forming the network structures, but carbon dioxide contains the discrete molecule due to the p orbital of carbon and oxygen overlap to form the pi bond. But in case of silicon is larger in size, silicon atom have larger in size, due to this silicon cannot form this type of structure like carbon dioxide. So this question can have the same answer if you ask that why carbon dioxide such question comes like what are the structural differences between carbon dioxide and silicon dioxide, that time you can answer in the same way. So this is the topic of discussion. I think you understand these discussions. If you have any question regarding these discussions, then you can ask me in the comment section. And if you find this video lecture is giving you some interesting things, or you are learning something, then you can like this video. And if you find this channel is educating you, giving you some education, then you can subscribe this channel.